não há para trás para tu tens este coração não vês
queire
este coração que é pequeno só isso é na 3S então abre-se na 3S que é muito que tudo você ele tem na 3S porque para original é 2S né mas qual boi scale boi mas eu provo e é caro muito não é tudo neta com o chuvach what captain gosta ei
well you well where hey what is this hey
well this was the beginning is
there is 1 minute without nothing hey.
Well, it was discussion in Slovenian because, in fact, I have the second bird prepared in the plane.
In the plane?
In the car. The FMS Trojan, the small one, of course. Since I'm doing the maiden flight, we have the wind again. I mean, this is unbelievable. Yeah. I can't say.
I wanted to try my token today, but I said I.
You can have the whole day without the wind, and when I come to this table and put the plane on, we have the wind every single time. Of course, we have the crosswind today. I mean, this is nothing. The crosswind is the sickest. If you have the side wind, it's good. The wind along the runway, but the crosswind is nothing. But who cares, say? We will try to do something because this plane was waiting for such a long time that this is unbelievable.
Hey, what? And over a year?
I don't know. But of course, first of all, friends, welcome to Petrinčić Brothers channel. The channel when we will try to test as many different planes as possible while we're filming. The channel when we don't edit nothing from the day one. This is the channel when you can see the truth about the planes.
I mean, hey, but is this plane, did this plane come with the landing gear or is this something?
Yeah, of course it comes. What's with you? You have crashed a plane like this, Captain Blush, a few years ago. Because I will tell you now, of course, the channel when we don't edit nothing from the day one, the channel, the last stand for an amateur pilot.
Yes.
Because here you can see what really happens. We don't pretend here, like we said, we don't edit. We are doing the maiden flights on the camera. So hey, you can judge me or not, because crash can happen. Every time you go to fly the plane for the first time, you don't know nothing about the plane.
Yes.
Your guess is as good as mine. You set yourself the perfect CG according to the manual. You set yourself the travels, check if everything is working, and then what? It's all in God's hand.
Yes, like today.
Yeah. Hey. And I will tell you this, Captain Blush, because you were asking the famous question, what do we have today? But this is something, eh? A beautiful and sexy Durafly. But this is unbelievable. This is unbelievable. Shut the phone.
You just speak.
Who is it?
Our mother.
The mother, what? No, I'm all distressed. The Durafly Vampire, 1100 millimeter wingspan that runs on full cell and it has 70 millimeter EDF unit on. Now, of course, this is still some old school EDF. In fact, it does have just 5 blades, so it will sound like a vacuum cleaner, but later you can upgrade yourself this plane, and maybe I will cap the blush for the second flight.
Yes.
Because, in fact, I do have at home a few 70mm EDF units with 12 blades, or at least 11, that can run on 4 cell, and that will make this.
Well, this is on 4 cell or 3?
This is on 4 cell, but it has only 5 blades, so that means that this will scream. But of course, the less the blades, the more efficient the that is, it doesn't suck so much amps, and that is what is interesting. Now, I had a plane like this before in the past, like Captain Blush said, the second EDF plane, in fact, was this Vampire. Now, Captain Blush, you were doing the maiden flight, we didn't even film back then, and
yes,
you have crashed it, so I have bought the second one, I have also crashed it on the maiden flight, fix it, and fly it again. But that plane is all crooked, and since there is an option for this beautiful and sexy Canadian scheme, I said to myself, what the hell, I will have the second one.
Well, salute our Canadian friends, eh?
I will salute our Canadian friends. Thanks for all support.
Yes.
This flight will be tributed to you. Even if we crash, who cares, eh? The point is that we are having fun on this channel, eh? Now, of course, what? Nothing else. This is it. I have said enough. Now, the price for this, I think that they still sell it on Hobby King. You will have the link below, because this is the option for you if you would love to fly this iconic, because this in fact is produced in the England, the iconic England or Great Britain jet fighter from the Cold War or something, eh? That it doesn't even cost much. Now you have the bigger versions of this, but they will cost you at least 2 times the money of this.
Yes.
One. But if you want to get just the experience how to fly this plane and how to
sometimes prepare, you can get more fun from a small one than a bigger one, eh?
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, the plane, I think, yes.
Yeah, and if you will crash this one, it will hurt less than if you crash the big one.
Well. Well, that's what she said, that it hurts less if it is smaller, yes.
Yeah, of course, we all know that, Captain Blush. And now I will plug it in. Now come here. Huh? One thing that I have done.
What?
I have put it also here two Velcros, because in fact, the magnet didn't hold too much, because here is such a small magnet, eh? So I don't want to pop this in the air. I have put this two Velcros.
Well.
And this will be interesting, because this will be the first time. Captain.
Well, Mark. Captain Mitic has actually tested these retcons a few times ago.
They
eh?
Work perfect, eh?
Yes.
But for me, it will be the first time that I will fly the retcon receiver, eh? And of course, you can see the position of the battery here. I have made myself a little nose-heavy plane, which it should be for the jets, and I hope for the best. Because in the past, we didn't show inside the compartment of the battery when we were filming. Now, even though we have a free videos of this plane, I don't know the position of the battery anymore, because I forget. Eh?
Yes.
So this is it, enough of the babbling.
Do you know what I like?
I will go in the middle.
The front landing gear slightly upward, this, slightly forward.
But look at this. Look, wait, I will close this. Look, the light is working on the receiver. I have done the rain check and it worked perfect. So, hey.
Don't you just like this smell of freshly cut grass?
This is the best smell. But you hear the crickets, they're so loud this year. Now I will show you the landing gear, which in fact are working. Look at this. It's still fresh. But look at this idea.
Yes.
You see this? Well, we put them out.
Look, push pull system.
And now look at the rudder.
What can be more simple?
Pretty interesting done. Now I was even able to take off with this plane without the carpet.
Carpet?
The carpet in the past. So I hope that today the carpet will work and I will not break the wheels. And these holes must be here.
Because wheels.
Remember, on the first launch of this plane, I have covered this.
Cheat holes.
The cheat holes, because I was curious about the EDFs and I thought that it will have an suction here to fly, but that was nothing. It fell on the ground like debris. Okay? So this
Stop postponing and just go
too
fly.
Much cheat holes, eh?
Yes.
I have set this to 4 minutes. I don't know why, which I will right now.
Change to three.
I don't know why I have put four. Because in fact, when we were filming this in the past, we didn't even check the battery consumption, so I don't know nothing, eh?
Yes.
I have seen the flight. It was around 4 minutes, but I won't.
Around 4 seconds, huh?
Yeah. Arrows! Right, left, up, down. Now the rudder is here on this plane, but only for the working front landing gear.
Yes.
And I will go in the mid-rates, and what the hell, eh?
Good luck.
Wish me good luck. Now, one thing that I have learned, and I hope that I will not forget, that this plane does need speed in the turns.
Yes.
Otherwise, it will tip stall like a brick.
Tip stall? Hey, what's this? Hey.
It will tip stall like a brick. Eh?
Are you dyslexic or what?
Of course, Captain Blush.
Yes. Tip stall. Oh, I need my sunglasses. Hey.
Hey, Captain Blush.
Do you know why? Because of your sexy white legs. Hey.
I don't want to know. Eh?
Yes.
Everybody's talking about my legs, but what's this? Some kind of
well, they're the same color as your t-shirt.
This is not a fashion show, this is a show about the planes, eh?
Yeah.
So this is it?
Yes.
I just hope for a big oh yeah this time, eh? Are you ready?
Yes. Good luck.
For something, eh?
Hey, what's this, hey?
Yeah.
Landing gear? Yes, perfect.
Well, hey.
Yes. What was that, hey? Some engine cutoffs.
The engine died twice.
Maybe it was not warm enough.
You see it good?
Yes. Just move from that spot right away.
You know what that was?
Yes, that
what this was?
What?
Sinaloa say. Are you mad?
Well,
hey,
what was this, eh?
Yeah, this was the signal loss, eh?
But how did Mitya?
Hey, nothing.
Hey, Mitya was flying 200 meters with that. What's that plane that you have, Swift?
Yeah, but these were the. Hey, these were the signal losses all over the place.
Yes, I could hear it. That yes.
Yeah, this is unbelievable, eh?
Hey, but the plane took off in 5 meters, eh?
Yeah, I will tell you this. I mean, I won't fly anymore. This is the end of story, eh? I mean,
is this the?
This was unbelievable.
Is this the conclusion that the red cone is nothing or what?
This is the conclusion, but I have put the antennas to the 90 degrees, and when I went there, there were positions. I think that maybe when the antenna was behind the. The battery or something, I have lost it. Because when I was standing like this, I have lost the signal there, I have turned, I just prayed to God and I have gained the signal again to here. Here I have lost
hey,
it again.
Do you have
it was okay? But in that direction it was okay.
But do you have do you have again the light that blinks or something, the red one?
Yeah, we will check right now, Captain Russian. Do you know what I will do?
What?
I will do, I mean, minute and a half, hey, but I have saved the plane, and this is unbelievable, hey. Now, this was very mature for me, of me to land. Let's check quick, because this was unbelievable. I mean, these were the signal losses all over the place, hey. This was nothing, hey. But it is the steady light, look. Yeah, maybe this one doesn't have the blinking light.
Well, the antennas, they're 90 degrees.
Yeah, but I don't know, maybe this one is not good. Do you see here?
Under the battery?
Yeah, it's not under the battery. Look, show the viewers. Look, one antenna is here because the end of antenna, it matters.
But this is not 90 degrees, eh?
Yeah, this is up. What's with you? That one is, the back of this one is up. How it's not? Yeah, how it's not this 19? Yeah, but what's with
but
you?
But you have cable like this and
yeah,
then
but who
up.
Cares about the cable? The end of the cable. This is the antenna, Captain Blush. This. The end of the antenna, not the whole cable. The tip of the cable is the antenna. Show inside here.
Yeah,
what
I have shown the video.
Yeah, again, I will be idiot here because you're saying that. This is 90 degrees. How it's not?
Well, it is, but
yeah, it
I don't
is.
Know.
Yeah, but what do you
yeah,
know?
Yeah, I think
yeah,
I know
how
that.
How can you have
but
the
who
cable?
Cares about that? All the thing I care is because this red cone is nothing, eh?
Yeah, but how can you have the antenna 90 degrees directly from the receiver? You can't have. That is why
next
you have
time,
a cable like this and then the tip is...
It's useless that we fight here because the
yeah,
next time
it is, eh?
Next time you will use antenna-less receiver and that's it.
Now what I have learned today, I mean, do you know what we will do? We will do another rain check, eh? Put the camera down, eh? This is unbelievable. I mean, I don't believe this. And I have landed pretty good today. Are you ready?
Yes.
Wait. Are you ready?
Yes.
30 meters. Wait.
The light didn't glitch.
Now turn it away from me. So this side will be hidden from the antenna.
Me?
Turn it away, around. Like this. More, put it on the table.
Huh?
Put it on the table.
Yeah, but see ya.
Towards me. Hide the up antenna from me.
You see ya, Taco?
More, no, more. Like this. Turn the plane a little.
The light is steady.
It's working good. But did you have any movement control?
No, nothing. It was total cut off of the plane. Total control loss. And when the power came up, it was again.
Well, the light was steady.
Yeah,
all
I don't know
time.
If even it blinks on this. I don't know if even it blinks. Now, wait, go to the camera.
Did you have a range check?
Yeah.
Well,
this is...
this is strange.
This is something, eh? Now, what I will do, I don't know.
Yeah, but it's interesting, because as I said, Mitya was flying these receivers with no problems, eh?
I just wonder about this one antenna, because when this antenna was away from me, I have lost the signal, this one that goes up. Then is what I was losing the signal.
Should you maybe put it out of the plane?
Oh, I don't know. Yeah, I won't risk nothing. I mean, I won't risk nothing anymore. I won't blame nothing this time. I will just be happy that the plane is in one piece. And I will tell you this. Even from this, I will tell you a little experience. Hey, the plane is amazing, okay? It was flying like on the tracks, and you have seen that it can take off without any problems, hey? Without any problems, hey? And it flies really good, and you have seen when I have landed back, even without the motor, because I have the assist of the wind, I was gliding back without any problems, hey?
And it
and
has
the plane
a lot of,
survived.
And it had a lot of power.
The power is really great, hey? And even the sound wasn't so bad. But I had the signal losses, and why was that? I will see. I will put inside here the original Spectrum receivers, antennaless, with which I don't have any problems lately. I was flying 20-30 planes lately with those, and I didn't have a single glitch, so I will put that one for the next, and I don't know.
What?
I don't know about this receiver. I don't know. It really was the... I mean, I don't know what it was, signal loss or power cut, but we will see on the next time if maybe something is wrong with EEC. But you have seen that if you put the throttle, the plane doesn't die.
You will see right away when you will put in the original receiver, Spectrum, antennaless, and you will see right away the result.
And we will try it again. Of course, this was the maiden flight, so what to tell at the end, eh? I can tell you that this is... I can tell you right now, I don't have to have the second flight to tell you that this plane really does fly great. All that you have to search is to have some speed in the turns, and the 2200 full cell battery in this position, the CG was great. The CG was really great, eh? Really great. But let's see the next time when I will have another receiver inside, and if that one will work, then I will make conclusion then, eh? I can give the assessment of this plane right now. By now, I will give it what? I will give it 9, eh?
Oh, good.
I will give it 9, which is pretty good. The one I have taken a little away just because these tail booms, I have seen that they don't have when I was assembling this plane. The assembly is pretty easy. It doesn't have no carbon bar, no nothing. Huh. So if you will land a little more crazy, maybe on the belly, and you will hit the back of the plane, it is possibility that you will break this, but during the assembly you can put inside the carbon bar, it's no problem, mate, and you will reinforce this plane and you will really have a really good experience. I can turn off the radio. You will have a good experience how it is to fly the beautiful, sexy, iconic Vampire, eh? So
yes,
this is it.
Yes.
Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off from Slovenia. What we have learned, another lesson again, eh? If you have the signal loss, and if you still have the options, land as quick as possible. Don't wait nothing. Because even a single something...
Well, that was a first for you, because usually you just keep trying, okay?
Well, I knew today that if I will go there, because I have almost lost the plane. There was a moment that I really thought that this would be the crash, but luckily I gained the signal back, so I didn't risk nothing anymore, and that is why we still have a beautiful and sexy plane in one piece, and it will be on the second filming, and then we will see what will happen, and then I think that we will enjoy this baby in all its glory. Maybe soon, Captain Blas. I hope soon, I also.
Yes.
So this is it. The Captain Blas, quick! Because the wind is stopping and we have another plane, FMS Trojan, to test.
Yes.
The small one, which will be perfect, because that one I would love to film without the wind. viewers, thanks again, and just expect more, eh? But, like I always say, we show it all, eh? I can pretend here and not post this, and do the perfect next flight, yeah, and pretend that I'm professional, that I never make mistakes and I don't try nothing, but that would be a lie, and on this channel we don't lie, we show you the truth, and something like this will and can happen to any of you, yes. Any of you. Maybe it was just the position of the receiver that was wrong, eh? Maybe I should have put it more in the back or somewhere, I don't know, but I won't even try anymore, I will just change it in that seat. Yes. Good enough, Captain Blush. Thanks, Captain Blush. I will salute you, eh?
Yeah, thanks.
For all the filming, say.